Thank you, Madam Chairman, and I must commend my colleague in the Senate for giving me such a great segue in that he chose exactly the right area of the comptroller's letter to recite to us. But we do diverge substantially in ideology, and so does the rest of the Republican side of the aisle. We do not believe, and I will repeat this again, we do not believe that we should be taxing at one of the worst economic times we've had in our history. We need to cut back in spending. Some of you know that I was away a few weeks ago attending the wedding of my youngest son in California, and while I was there, the only thing you could hear in the news was about their huge budget gap. And at that time, they were one of four states without a budget deal yet. Now we are one of only three in the entire country. But what did they do when they no longer could issue IOUs that were being given out in a way to pay their bills? And no longer were those being accepted. They actually had to get down and do something historic. And what they did was they brought back their spending to 2005 levels. And yet I see here today that we're not doing even going back to 2007 or 2008 or 2009. We're going upward. We're actually spending money. And to me, this is absolutely the wrong direction for us to go in. And I might also add that our good leader of the House was quoted just recently in Bloomberg on the 28th, where he was mentioned when they discussed the budget crisis throughout this country and they highlighted Connecticut. He said the fundamental difference is that Democrats believe we can have a tax on those making over $500,000, and that can make up the difference. And we're pretty much done. My goodness. I don't know that any of us truly believes that. And also, we should know, who are these wealthy? There's only very few that most of you are probably thinking of. The vast majority are individuals creating jobs. And you know, we have some other states right now that are addressing that issue, and some of them are going in the opposite direction. The state of Maine, a completely Democratic state, House and Senate and governor, they found that their millionaire's tax was so devastating to the jobs of their state that they are actually bringing it down. They're going down to 6%. New York just today was reported that they are losing jobs as well, that it's somewhat counterproductive, some of these graduated taxes. And Maryland lost a third of all their millionaires, as such, lost a lot of their jobs. We don't have to look very far for this. And additionally, July 28th, we have the Wall Street Journal giving us a graph of all of the states in the country telling us when we were going to recover from the recession. When were we going to get our jobs back? There are only a few states that go all the way out to 2005. Most of them, 2010, 2011, but Connecticut is paired up there till 2015 with Illinois, Indiana, Michigan, Ohio. These are the states we're being compared with. It's incredible, and we can understand some of these states. Detroit, of course. Gary, Indiana, of course. But Connecticut, this is not my Connecticut, the Connecticut that I knew. I have to tell you, this is making me very emotional. And when I look at what we're really talking about here, we're really talking about these one-time shots, such as the stimulus money and the $800 in borrowing and the one-time shots and the rainy day fund. We are going to have such a hole in 2012. I am very worried about this. We're using with this budget is not only additional spending, but we're also talking about closing a gap by just changing a forecast. I have to tell you all that you can tell I am very, very concerned. Our own departments and staff are talking about how we have a problem here, and certainly this is not the way to do it. We hope if there aren't better solutions, then hopefully those of us on the Republican side can come back and maybe present a few really good ideas in the very near future. Thank you, Madam Chair.